Good vision is a key factor for living a healthy, happy life. The earlier we start looking after the health of our eyes, the better our chance of maintaining good vision throughout our lives. Vision problems can occur at any age, which is why regular eye examinations with an ophthalmologist are important. Good vision isn't just about seeing well, it's about living well. One such eye affection is glaucoma. Glaucoma is a group of eye conditions that damage the optic nerve, which is vital for good vision. Worldwide, glaucoma is the second leading cause of irreversible blindness. At MediCircle, we're conducting an awareness series on glaucoma with eminent ophthalmologists for the World Glaucoma Day to boost awareness and educate people about eye health. Hi, this is Sana Khan, and today in this initiative, we're going to speak to Dr. Urmi Shah. Dr. Urmi Shah is a cataract surgeon and medical retina specialist. She consults out of two clinics in Mumbai, that is Eye Solutions, Kemp's Corner, and All Doctors Clinic at Walkeshwar. She is a highly skilled clinician and surgeon, providing her patients with spot-on diagnosis and excellent surgical results. She treats various retinal diseases like diabetic retinopathy, retinal vein occlusions, and age-related macular degeneration by giving intravitreal injections, intravitreal implants, or retinal laser. Other than retinal conditions, she has great expertise in managing general ophthalmology problems like glaucoma, eyelid problems, eye infections, dry eyes, and uveitis. Hi, Urmi, how are you? Welcome to MediCircle.
Thank you so much. Doing very well. Thank you so much for that kind introduction.
It's our pleasure. Okay, Urmi, who is at risk of developing glaucoma, and does aging increase any chances of glaucoma?
Before I answer that, I would just like to speak a few words on what exactly glaucoma is. Mm-hmm. You have already very well introduced the topic, but basically it is something where our eye pressure mm-hmm. starts to increase, and that starts to affect the nerve of the eye, which you mentioned as the optic nerve.
Right.
And with time, this leads to a progressive loss in our visual field. Mm-hmm. By visual field, we mean that when I'm looking at something, I can still see everything else around me, even right. if I'm focusing on a particular object.
Right.
That is known as my entire field of vision.
Okay.
So what happens in glaucoma is that with time, as the pressure stays high, this field of vision starts constricting. So the patients start losing their peripheral vision,
right.
which then in advanced stages starts reaching the center.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I think you all are doing an excellent job by trying to create awareness on this topic, because there is not enough information available out there for people. I mean, a lot of my patients, most of the people I know, are not even aware that there is something known as eye pressure.
Right.
When I tell my patients that I need to check your eye pressure, they tell me that, oh, but my blood pressure is normal. And I have to tell them that eye pressure is something which is different from their blood pressure.
Mm-hmm.
So the awareness starts at that level to understand that we have something known as an eye pressure. And what happens when that eye pressure starts rising?
Okay.
So basically, glaucoma is typically of two types.
Mm-hmm.
One is known as a primary open-angle glaucoma, where essentially the structure of the eye is normal.
Okay.
The second is something known as an angle closure glaucoma, where the angles of the eye are narrower.
Okay.
So there is a block to the flow of the fluid inside the eye.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that block, the eye pressure can suddenly rise. That is known as angle closure glaucoma.
Okay.
So the risk factors, as you were saying, who is at risk for developing glaucoma? For both of these conditions, the risk factors are a little different.
Okay.
For primary open angle glaucoma, one of the main risk factors is a positive family history.
Okay.
Today, about 50% of patients who have this type of glaucoma will have a positive family history.
Mm-hmm.
And any glaucoma person, their first degree relatives will have a 10 times higher chance of developing glaucoma themselves.
Okay.
By first degree relatives, we mean their parents, siblings, or their children, the right. direct blood relations. So it is very important for any relative, a first degree relative of a person with glaucoma, to get their eyes regularly screened once a year after the age of 40.
Okay.
The other thing is an important factor that can lead to higher eye pressures is steroid usage.
Okay.
Steroid drops are very frequently used for a number of different eye conditions. And for people who are on steroid drops, it's very important to monitor your eye pressures regularly, because that can also cause the pressures to go up. Or even people who are taking steroid tablets or steroid creams, all of them need to monitor their eye pressures. There is also a certain type of professionals who might be at an increased risk of developing a higher eye pressure. For example, some musicians who play these high resistance wind instruments like trumpets.
Okay.
For example, scuba divers or weightlifters, because all of them, there might be episodes where their eye pressures are increasing because of the nature of their work.
Okay.
So they too need to get their eyes screened regularly. This is for our open angle glaucoma. For narrow angle glaucoma, it is more common in people who have smaller eyes.
Okay.
Okay, because that leads to crowding of structures at the angle and a block to the outflow. Okay. It is again a little bit more common in females, and it definitely increases with increasing age.
Okay.
So coming to the next part of your question, that does it increase with increasing age? The answer is yes. It is very rare to have somebody below the age of 40 with glaucoma. Mm-hmm. But after 40, what I do is in my practice, any patient who walks in, even for just a number checkup, but if they are above 40, I routinely check their eye pressures whenever they come to see me.
Okay.
Because in an open angle glaucoma, our normal pressure range is from 10 to 21 for all adults.
Okay.
If the pressures are staying at a level of 24, 25, or even 30, a lot of times the patient will have no symptoms because of this.
Right, right, right.
But only when it is checked at the clinic, which is when we can pick up that the eye pressures are higher than normal, and then we need to look into the whole glaucoma workup.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Urmi, is glaucoma preventable?
So, glaucoma is typically the name given when the eye pressure has started to affect the nerve and the patient has started to lose vision.
Okay.
So yes, if the higher eye pressures are picked up early and they are controlled, we can stop the patient from reaching the stage where it has started to damage the optic nerve.
Okay.
We cannot control which patient, we cannot control a patient developing high eye pressure, but we can put a stop to that by that it doesn't go and affect the optic nerve. Mm-hmm. Also, in patients who have an angle closure variety, the moment narrow angles are detected by a procedure known as gonioscopy,
okay,
a laser procedure can be done for them, which is known as a laser PI or a peripheral iridotomy, which helps to open up the passage of the fluid, which is getting blocked, mm-hmm, in narrow angle glaucoma, so that the pressure buildup does not occur.
Okay.
So yes, in that way, there are ways to kind of keep the entire disease under control.
Take it. And Urmi, is there any no cure for glaucoma, or is this a myth or reality?
So again, I wouldn't say that there's no cure. See, glaucoma is very often likened to somebody having blood pressure or diabetes.
Right.
There is nothing that you can give somebody that is going to cure their blood pressure, right? Mm-hmm. But they have to be on medication which is going to keep it under control.
Right.
So which is the case also for glaucoma. For somebody who has an open angle glaucoma, they have to be on lifetime drops. Okay. These, and they have to be extremely regular with these drops. Okay. And if they are regular with their drops, if they come in for regular monitoring, the eye pressures need to be checked every 3 months, the visual fields need to be checked once in 6 or 8 months. So if these things are done regularly, then we can help to control the way the disease is progressing.
Mm-hmm.
And what we are actually aiming to prevent is we're aiming to prevent the blindness.
Right. Right.
That if there are a lot of patients, you know, who do not realize the importance of their condition. They do not realize that this is something which can help them lose their vision.
Right.
They do not realize that they need to put their drops. And then they end up with that end stage disease where they have lost most of their vision. So that is what that we want to prevent.
That also may be because they do not have any symptoms. So they don't realize the seriousness of that issue.
Yes, exactly. So right. What happens with an angle closure glaucoma is that the eye pressure suddenly rises.
Mm-hmm.
The eye pressure might suddenly go up to 50 or 55. And right. The patient will suddenly have severe eye pain, headache, vomiting, blurry vision. So they will immediately seek help for that.
Right.
But somebody who has an open angle glaucoma, the pressures are rising very slowly and gradually. And mm-hmm. even at pressures of 26 or 30, it is causing damage to the eye nerve, which they have not realized. Which is why it's very important for them, everybody over the age of 40, to regularly get your eye pressures checked once a year.
Mm-hmm.
And if somebody is diagnosed with glaucoma, then realize the importance of the condition, be regular with the medications. I mean, I have some patients who come in so regularly for their checkups. Every 3 months, they give a call and say, it's time for my eye pressure, I'm coming. It's time for my feels, I'm coming. And since the last so many years, there's not been even the slightest change in her nerve.
Wow.
And her vision is perfect because it is being regularly monitored.
Monitored.
And at the other end of the spectrum, yes, monitored and medicated. And at the other end of the spectrum, there are people who are not realizing the importance, or they become lax about putting the drops, you know, and the, in them, the vision loss keeps progressing.
Okay.
So that is what we want to prevent.
Umi, what factors cause blindness in the case of glaucoma?
So blindness, I would say the factors causing blindness are a little more patient related than actual disease related, as we just discussed.
That
if the patients are not taking the medications regularly, not putting the drops regularly, if they're not monitoring, sometimes you could be putting your drops, but those level of drops are not enough to stop the progression. And you will know only if you get your visual fields done every 6 months. Mm. And if we feel that, yes, with these two drops, the disease is still progressing, then you add another medication. If it is still progressing, okay, you might have to go in for surgery.
Okay.
So these are all the decisions that need to be taken. But today, if you're just putting the drops and not going in for monitoring, not checking what's happening to your visual fields, not getting your pressures checked, then definitely you're on the way to losing your vision.
Right.
And at the other end is the angle closure glaucoma, where if the pressure suddenly rises, as we discussed. Now, what happens is the patients, they present with a severe headache, sometimes even with nausea, vomiting.
Okay.
And typically for that, they might go and see the general practitioner first.
Right.
Now, general practitioners do not realize that it is an eye condition.
Mm-hmm.
They might not ask them to get their eyes checked. I recently had a patient where very nicely the general practitioner realized that the eye is red and immediately sent him across for the eye pressure checkup. And he was very, very well managed, and we had, you know, managed to preserve his vision excellently. And he's seeing amazingly well because things were picked up and diagnosed on time.
The right stage, right.
At the
early,
right stage.
Early diagnosis is very important.
For the angle closure, yes. And for the open angle, as I said, regular monitoring after the age of 40. Do not just go to an optician and get your number checked. Go to an eye doctor who will also check your eye pressure and who will also check your retina to see if there are any changes which are occurring. Like, just on this note, I would just want to share one patient experience that I had where, you know, she was, I think, about an 85-year-old lady who had come because she said, I'm just not able to see well. And when I saw, she had advanced glaucoma in both eyes.
Okay.
Now, the sad part was that she had been diagnosed with glaucoma by a very leading glaucoma specialist about 6-7 years ago.
Okay.
And at that point, her visual fields were normal.
Okay.
Or were showing very early changes. And she had been asked to put the drops. But, you know, as we discussed, that was not done. It was not monitored. And over 6 to 7 years, she had lost her vision to the extent where she could just probably see a few feet distance.
Okay.
And she told me, my only wish is that I want to see the face of my grandson, who's getting married in a few months.
Oh my God.
And that moment was heartbreaking because there was nothing that anybody can do to give her back that vision. And the fact that it could have been prevented. The whole importance of glaucoma awareness comes in, where you can pick up a patient on time and stop them from reaching that end stage. Because once you've reached that stage, the vision loss is irreversible.
But would mean that depends on the patient themselves also, because they
that's what I'm saying.
They need not create so much of negligence. This is
So see, it's both ways, right? First of all,
right.
It's the doctor's responsibility to explain to them what exactly glaucoma is. Today, if I get a patient and I say, "Acha, aapko glaucoma hai aur aap ye drops dalo," nobody is going to understand why they need to put the drops for lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
So as an ophthalmologist, it is our duty to explain to them, take out those extra 5 minutes, that see, this is the condition you have. And if you don't do this, this is what is going to happen.
Right.
That is the doctor's responsibility. But it's the patient's and the relative's responsibility to ensure that that is followed so that they do not reach that end stage blindness. Today, somebody who is losing vision because of cataract, it can easily be reversed because you do a cataract surgery and you get your vision back.
True, correct.
But glaucoma is something which we don't discuss often enough, and something which is going to cause that irreversible blindness.
That is why it is called the thief of sight.
Yeah. I call it the silent killer, you know.
Right.
In all of my posts, I always describe it because it's just creeping up silently. You're not aware of it.
You're not aware.
And by the time you become aware, it is so late that nobody can do anything about it.
Right. Okay. Thank you so much, Dr. Urmi, for being here, for sharing your valuable time and insights with us. It has been a pleasure.
Thank you so much, Sabha. Yes, thank you to MediCircle. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.